Bear is a note-taking app, and it is also the second note-taking app that I'll be reviewing for this series. And here is why. Unlike the first one I reviewed, Craft, which is packed with tons of features, a lot of customizations, and extra features that makes it more than a note app, which is good for some people and starting to become too much for people who just need a simple note-taking app. And I think this is where Bear comes in. It is a stripped-back, simple, Markdown-first version of a lot of note-taking apps out there, which incorporates to-do, task manager, calendar integrations, and a lot more things than just taking notes. This is why I like the simplicity, the design, and the approach of Bear to taking notes. So let's take a look at the interface of Bear and see how it's different from other note-taking apps out there. So first, let's start with the settings. Settings are very minimal. You can change things that you want in general if you wanted to. If you want to up your text font, your heading font, even your code font, text size, just regular things that you would expect a note taker to have. And you have a choice of themes. There's quite a variety of themes. I kind of like this. You can change the app icon here and it reflects immediately. So if we go to something like this, lake, we can see on here it's reflected. If we go to something red, same thing over here. I'm just gonna leave it back at blueberry. And sync, so this is syncing your notes together. When you open Bear, this is the interface you get. It's very clean, very simple, and it feels like what a note taker app should be. So on the left panel here, there is an all notes dropdown, which shows you all of your untagged notes, your to-dos, today, locked, and trash. Here are your tags, which are folders, and you can have nested tags, which functions like folders in folders for organization. In the middle pane here, you get a preview of all of your notes, and depending on the selection you pick. And this right pane here shows the preview of the note. If you swipe to the left, you can hide this pane here so you can focus more on your notes, which I think is a really nice touch. Another thing you can do with notes is delete it by swiping to the right or pin by swiping this way. Let's look at the top here. So here is the history navigation. You can go back and forward. Here are some formatting options. And what this does is essentially bring up a floating bar that gives me quick access to some formatting options, which we'll come back to later. This gives me statistics of the current note I'm viewing, table of contents, heading from the note, and backlinks. I'm going to create a new note here and call it a new note. So if I wanted to put this in a new folder, all I have to do is create a new tag. And you do that with double pound sign, and let's call this folder A. And right here, we can see folder A already appearing. So this note is now in folder A. So if I come on here and I click this, here's the new note. And if I want to put a folder in folder A, it's as simple as creating a new note, giving it a title, but in folder B. So now in folder A, there is a folder B that contains another note. So it's a different way of organization, but I think it works, and once you get used to it, it's fairly simple. So one of the shortcomings of Markdown is the table implementation, and Bear has actually done a good job of making tables easy to work with. If I hover on the image, I get this handle, and I can do this. So I can resize images. Let's add a new note on here. And here I can start to go Markdown. There we are. And as I keep typing, it hides that. And I can just keep going. Now I can just highlight this and come over here and just bold it. So I don't have to memorize the Markdown writing style. Do this in italics it. There is no way to have multiple notes open in the same window. So the only way is to have it in another window. You can share through all these options, but there is no way to have a real-time collaboration. You can also export the note in a variety of different formats, in all of these formats here. There is a certain appeal to how Bear lets you take notes in probably one of the most distraction-free environments that I've seen of any note-taking app. If you're serious about taking notes in the simplest way possible, it is hard to not love the simplicity and the distraction-free features that Bear offers, as well as the Markdown first writing style. And this is good enough to make me keep coming back to it. And for a lot of people out there, it probably is good enough. So in this sense, less is more, and I'm all for it. Let's talk about price. Now, the good news is there's a free version that is usable. And this gives people a chance to try it out, see if it's something they'd like. Now, on the flip side, there is no one-time payment. So it's a subscription model and will cost you $3 a month or about $30 a year. Now, overall, I want to keep this short and simple. Bear delivers as a note-taking app in the simplest, most pleasing way possible. And it doesn't try to over-deliver by adding features that are just unnecessary for a note-taking app to have. It's not perfect because there are some features that I would like to see added to Bear, but I think it is really up there when it comes to pure note-taking apps. It's definitely a 4.3 out of 5 for me. So that's my review of Bear. If you don't know, now you know.